Hello, Chris.
Hello, mate.
I just want to remind you of something.
This
is the fourth Thor
this
film.
This guy.
Stupidly not called for Thor, but fine. It's safe to say that this gig has paid off. You've been Thor for 11 years now. Just so you know, your rival is this Hugh Jackman guy with 16 years in the playing a superhero character for the longest time stakes.
Is he?
Would you possibly be seeing yourself still swinging Mjolnir / Stormbreaker in 6 years' time to beat that record?
I wasn't gonna, but now that you've put that in front of me, you make a good point. It's only 6 years. I've come this far. You know, to turn back now would just be a waste.
Yep.
So
you've just got to hope that he doesn't do a cameo in Deadpool 3, because that just ruins it.
Then it's I know. I might make some calls, make sure that doesn't happen. Yeah.
It's a good plan. I like it.
I might put myself in Deadpool instead. That would be the offering, I think, you know. See if that, you know, passes. Yeah.
From your lips to God's ears. I love it.
Oh,
we're talking
God.
Late March 2022. There's not been
so
a trailer
hard.
At this point for Love and Thunder. I've not seen the film. This is a Zoom interview on ultra hard mode. My best insight into this movie right now, and it isn't a joke, is a Lego set. Pray for me. I know this.
What?
Goats
I
are involved.
This.
What can you tell me about them?
Why there are goats?
Well, how do you know about the goats? Anyway.
The trailer.
The goats are, I've seen a few versions of the film, and they scream a lot in the most manic.
Oh my God. How much work, how much dedication, bro? This is hard shit. Really, bro, GG. I am like legit impressed because I started working out, going to the gym, weightlifting, and bro!
I think your right arm is approximately the size of my whole body. Was this actually just to prove that the whole...
Thor, what do you know?
Endgame Thor look was very much a joke.
Is he asleep?
No. I'm pretty sure he's dead.
It was just him coming back with a vengeance, I think.
After saving planet Earth for the 500th time, Thor set off on a new journey.
Well, he got we all shape. Love some transformation,
He
bro.
Went from dead bod to god bod.
It was like me in lockdown for seven months.
Corona.
And I was just like, what else to do but train and eat and train and eat and, you know, it's just my sort of prison mentality. And I grew and grew and grew.
It paid off.
And then the trickiest thing was trying to maintain that size. I got to sort of peak condition and then kind of flatline
through
the film.
Oh, yeah, like shredded and...
You know,
and
pay attention early because I'll dwindle off throughout.
As you rewatch the film, you go, that was the end of the shoot, beginning of the shoot.
Because your percent of fat is to be low.
I can tell you what month it is by how small I was getting.
You have muscles?
I cannot wait for the director's and actor's commentary. A quick question on the Endgame bod, right? If Tony Stark calls Thor Big Lebowski...
Drifting left. Side there, Lebowski.
And Jeff Bridges played his former mentor in Iron Man.
Oh, that went well.
Have I found a key mistake in the MCU that just unravels it all?
I think you have, yeah. I didn't even think of that myself. Well done.
You're welcome, world. I've ruined your favorite thing for you.
A little forensic investigation there on your behalf. Well done.
Oh, man, my thinking about this case had become very uptight, yeah.
As my mum often says, you could have been a doctor.
You should have been, right? Well, we wouldn't have got to hang out, so.
Yeah.
And that would have been a travesty. What I can also see is you in a sleeveless, but of course, white tee with this amazing print. Is the print a clue? Is that something we can talk about?
This is, okay, that is, what could I say about that? The tank top you're talking about, right?
Yeah.
Now, it could be a few different trees, right? It could be the, what's it, Yggdrasil, I think it's called, the sort of tree of life.
Uh-huh.
It could be a tree from the film. It could be Tree of Life by Terrence Malick.
Yep.
He could have also co-directed.
Yeah, that's
I don't
a deep
know.
Cut. For all you Brad Pitt fans.
Boy, that's right.
Here we go. Here we go.
Here you go.
And after all that,
Mjolnir.
He reclaimed his title as the one and only Thor.
Oh, spoke too soon.
Jane?
Taika has said that the sequel is so over the top in the very best way that it's as if 10-year-olds told us what should be in a movie and we said yes to every single thing.
Yeah.
What is your best example of that you can give me?
Ghost.
Yeah, it was 10-year-old Taika, or Taika, who is like a 10-year-old, saying, can I have this person in the film? Can we do this? Can we have goats? Can we have this? Can we have that? And they said, yep. And then off you go, and it's like, how do we assemble this into a film? It was...
Well, you got all the toys.
Yeah, exactly. That's how he would storyboard, you know, a bunch of action figures. And you're over here, and you're over here, and you do this. Look, it was just him at his kind of wackiest and most insane, in a beautiful, beautiful way, trying and experimenting, exploring all sorts of ideas and concepts.
No, it's
and
Batman.
Everyone was on board and along for the ride, and it was a hell of a ride, as only he could do.
You also have your first Thor movie here without Tom Hiddleston. It seems like you've replaced that focus-stealing son of a gun with everyone.
Remember what I told you. You ever feel lost? Just look into the eyes of the people that
man,
you love.
Look at
the Guardians, Christian Bale, cameos we can't mention. Natalie Portman is back.
Not me.
What? Just listening.
I was wondering, did you ever find yourself God-splaining Thor to Natalie Portman? Like, here's how to best swing Mjolnir. You don't want to swing it quite like that. Your cape work needs work.
I mean, she didn't need much advice. I just want to say that was very, very impressive what you did back there. Yeah, a couple of times she asked me, and it was about kind of 2 months in.
She's just my first bad guy.
About kind of a stance or a
I
thing.
I wish her biceps were real.
I was honored that she'd asked, and I thought, sure, I'll get, you know, to say, kind of do a bit of this. And, but other than that, she had a pretty good hand on it all herself. She was fantastic and worked her butt off and came in incredible shape and made us all have to pick up our own gun.
What's it been like? 3-4 years?
8 years, 7 months and 6 days.
Absolutely. And I know we can't talk about the cameos, but I am curious to discover that maybe Matt Damon is back.
Build a statue for me.
We will build a big statue for you.
With my helmet on, with the big bendy horns.
Can you say that he's going to be Loki again? What can you say?
You know I can't say anything. I mean, it's
all right.
I you know, yeah. But.
Yeah. I'm dead. Oh, nice reference.
Interviews are fun.
You know, especially when you haven't seen the film, isn't it? You're doing a brilliant job, though. I must say thank you.
Sir, so kind. All right, let me ask a few wrap-up questions.
Stop being
what
so
are
handsome.
Fans in the street saying to you these days? And I'm particularly interested in what Aussie fans say
no
to you.
No way
when
the movie's going
to
be banned.
Aussie fans, it's like, oh, g'day, Chris. Or it's or occasionally Thor. Mostly it's Thor. So if it's a drive-by, it's Thor out the window. If it's in person, there's a little more gentleness. But
I like
it's all pretty positive.
The greeting, way. What would you say has been your most memorable direction playing Thor? And I'm imagining Taika's got the best ones in terms of, I'm never going to hear a note like that ever again.
Yeah. Don't do it like that again. It was, you know.
Wrong.
Wrong. No.
Bad.
Shut up. Don't do that. Or I'd be like, oh, can I try something here? He goes, sure, if it's better than my writing, great, do it.
Good luck, chump.
Most of the time, the biggest challenge, I think, editorially or for the sound mixing department is, like, through some of our best takes, he's just laughing in the background over the top of all of it. And I'm like, how does any of this cut together? And so I'll be in the ADR booth having to re-record those lines minus his heckle.
No way!
Yeah, him chuckling or a random goat noise.
Goat noise.
Taika, could you just not? And let me leave you with this. Where is the weirdest place you've seen your face as Thor? Whether it's merchandise or, I don't know, a pillowcase and lunchbox.
I've seen a few pairs of, like, underwear. I've seen a couple of tattoos on a butt cheek.
Oh,
which is whoa, there it is. Okay, cool, thanks.
Yeah.
Well, this is a great way of ending the interview, actually, Chris.
Thank you. Here it is.
Time for me to just...
thought you were going to do it. If only. That would have been, I'm happy to re-record this if you go get a tattoo quickly and I'll play
give
it like
six
it was
months
the first time it happened.
And a lot of money.
Done.
I'm your guy.
All right. 6 months to get the tattoo? Come on.
I need a bill of the courage, I think.
All right.
And maybe beg my
Does
wife.
He have
anyway,
a tattoo, though?
Chris, as ever, it's been a sincere pleasure.
Does Chris
have a great
have a
rest
tattoo?
Of your day.
Thank you, buddy.
I can't
you
wait
oh, yeah,
to see the trailer for
hand.
This film.
Can't wait to see the goats.
Yes.
Thanks for watching.
We all want to see the goats. Okay, those are sheep. Those are not goats. I can't even make a goat sound. I'm the window's open. The neighbors can hear me.